Hey, it's Motion Design School. My name is Sasha. I'm an illustrator and a motion designer in the school. Today I'm going to break down this animation. I've drawn and animated it frame by frame in Photoshop, and then I pieced everything together and made the final touches in After Effects. So, let's get started. As always, everything begins with a sketch. At first, I sketch out the main outline and the composition center, where this girl becomes the center. Then I gradually began to finalize the image. Usually I need to redraw a sketch 2 or 3 times to start drawing a line. I also don't forget about adding the details. It's essential to strike a balance in your illustration. For example, the background here is pretty overloaded with tiny details, but the character in the foreground doesn't have too much of them. Another plus is that characters like that are quick to animate, because they have few details. And after I've got the line right, I went straight to animating it. I'm going to say a few words about animating in Photoshop. For this purpose, there's the timeline panel in the Windows tab. Select it and click Create Video Timeline. Now you have this timeline where you can animate. You can do this with the standard layers by simply creating a layer and adjusting it on the timeline. This animation method is ideal for the rough stage when you need to figure out the timing. But it isn't suitable for drawing a full-fledged animation due to the huge number of frames and consequently layers. There is more convenient way, which is video layers. To create one, simply choose Layer, Video Layer, New Blank Video Layer. Using them, you can draw on each frame without creating a new layer. To make your life even easier, you can install the free AnimDesign 2 plugin. It displays all the necessary functions on a panel in Photoshop, and you don't need to go to the timeline menu each time. But this is a story for another day. I will animate in 12 FPS. For that, I set the timeline frame rate to the value I needed. You can adjust the onion skin parameter, render the animation, and much more in the same menu. I will begin with the legs. To make things easier, I've animated the legs as sticks with dots for joints. Also for convenience, I draw an arc with spacing along which the leg will move. Most objects move in arc, so it's essential to keep it in mind as the character's bone length should never change. Also, don't forget about the secondary motion. Here are the toe legs slightly behind the movement of the lower leg. After finishing drawing the legs, I get down to the hair. To animate them, I used Ben Marriott's wave tip. By the way, we've got his super course on frame-by-frame animation. Here's the link, you can also find it in the description section. The tip is all about drawing a wave and moving it frame by frame until the next phase. Here, I simply traced the wave with the lasso tool, copied and pasted it into the next frame, and slightly moved it. Also, I put a layer with the frame on top, so that the wave's edges didn't distract me and only the area I needed was visible. Like this. And then I drew a lock of hair on top of it. And did so until the ends of the face on each frame. You can use this trick for another wave-like objects such as fire or smoke. Then I do this with each lock of hair. Done. Now I did the same with the character t-shirt. Drawing the wave on the lower and upper part of it and on the sleeves. Here is the result. Let's get down to animating the legs. I started sketching the legs using the lines drawn earlier. Pay attention to the foot. Since I drawn the character in 3 quarters, I need to similarly draw the foot. And otherwise, it will look like it turned in the other direction. To make your work easier and figure out the foot's position when it's turned, you can simplify it to a primitive shape. In my case, it's a parallelepiped. I drawn a little clue on the side to know what the foot like in the top, bottom and middle position. This simplification method helps you understand how different objects will move in space. This way you can simplify the legs, head and other body parts to simple and clear objects. Before I start finalizing it, I found a nasty bug in the animation of the leg. During the animation, the bend of this leg constantly travels up and down, changing the leg's length. It's an important aspect because you always need to maintain the character's proportions. Otherwise, the animation will look broken and unrealistic. Keep in mind that it's always easier to fix everything during the rough stage, rather than when the line and fill are done. Okay, I'm done with the rough animation, everything looks good to me here, and now I can get down to the line. At this stage, I draw all the objects on different layers. One leg is one layer, the t-shirt is a separate layer, each lock of hair is on separate layer. This is quite tiresome and lengthy process, but it's crucial stage because you need to be careful, keep the line smooth and maintain its thickness. When I'm drawing the line, I prefer using this standard Photoshop brush. I like it because a little texture and rough. This brush adds some style and fits the character well into the environment. Also, don't forget to check the animation so as not to miss some frames. Done, the animated line is ready. I can now begin coloring everything. For starters, I color the background. For that, I used a big texture brush to sketch out the color in large spots. Since it's the night time in the illustration, I made the background dark and foreground light, since the light comes from the pool and illuminates the character. When the main spots are ready, I colored everything in more detail. I've also drawn additional objects to animate them in the background. There are waves in the pool, I made them in the form of rectangular because I will later add the deformation effect to them. I've also added fireflies and couple of stars on the background. I've drawn everything on separate layers and named them accordingly to keep things organized. Then I started coloring the animation itself. As it was for the line, I've created separate layers in case I'll decide to change the color. This way it's easier to do so. And I started coloring them. It felt like it was the longest stage of all, because I always had to adjust the fill outside the lines or on the contrary, to finish coloring sometimes. That is done. I have almost finalized the animation, I just need to prepare everything for importing into After Effects and assemble the animation there. The first one is the background with the additional elements for the animation, I have deleted the timeline. The other one is the frame-by-frame animation. It helps to organize the project a bit, because when your video layers are imported into After Effects, the program interprets them as a video file, and it's not convenient to work with static objects in this case. Having imported the source files into After Effects, I've assembled the character in a separate composition. Some parts of the animation overlapped each other or appeared in all the wrong places, so I had to mask them out. Also, I've decided to add depth to the character by adding shadow to it. I drew a shape in the form of the character, colored it blue, set the blend mode to multiply and set transparency to 50%. I've also added a shadow to the other leg, arm and hair, and set the same parameters for them, multiply and transparency. And I've also masked some places out. This way the character will have more depth and will better fit the environment. After I made the pink spots on the knees. For that, I drawn a shape, applied Gaussian blur and set mat to it, so that the shape doesn't exceed the leg. Then I've animated the pass parameter by the position of the knee. I've made the same thing with the other shape. Okay, the character is ready. I can now get down to animating the background. First, I've animated the waves in the pool. For that, I've applied the wave warp effect and the grow bounce effect to the wave layer, so that the animation of the waves doesn't trim. And now by simply copying the effect, I pass it into the other wave, but I've changed the face in the wave warp setting, so that the waves don't move identically. The waves look final. Then I started animating the fireflies. I pre-compiled them not to have too many layers in the timeline. The fireflies move chaotically. You can achieve this effect by using a looped wiggle expression. You can read more about it in our blog. You can find the link in the description section. I've applied this expression to the position property. I slightly adjusted the settings to perfectly loop the movement in my composition. I've made the same thing with the opacity property. Then I've copied the fireflies and arranged them in the composition. Back in the main composition, they look nice. I moved on to the stars. I've simply passed the loop wiggle expression to the opacity parameter, adjusting the necessary settings. It's almost ready, but there are no splashes when the feet emerge from under the water. To achieve that, I've rendered the character sequence and imported it to Photoshop. The frame rate is set to 12 FPS. I've created a new video layer and simply drawn the splashes on top of it. I've also added a few bubbles to imitate that the feet are submerging into the water. This animation is quick to create, and it took me less than 30 minutes to make it. Then I've imported everything into After Effects, passed the animation, and added the glow effect to the splashes. It's also looped for the entire length of the composition. The animation is almost done. To create the glow that emanates from the pool, I created an adjustment layer and applied the glow to it. I set up the parameters as I needed and mask out a part of the effect because I didn't want the entire composition to glow, but only the pool with the character. Then I applied the green effect and set up the parameters I needed. And lastly, I've added a slight chromatic aberration. Firstly, I pre-compiled the entire animation, and then I've used the RGB separation effect from the Trapcode Universe plugin. But you can achieve the same effect without the plugin. Simply copy the composition 3 times and apply the set channel effect to them, setting the necessary parameters on each layer. Set the blend mode to add, and then offset one composition by 1 or 2 pixels, and that's it. If you want to examine everything in detail and find out what is left behind the scenes, you can download the source project in the link below. Thank you so much for watching. Like and share the video if you learned something new or useful. Suggest the topic you'd like us to cover in our next videos. And subscribe to Motion Design School and me. See you soon!